Today we are still hanging out in the Dutch village here at the Harvestman Expo, and I've run into a dairy farmer from the Netherlands. He's going to tell us how dairy farming is different with that in Uganda. Hello, how are you?
Hello, I'm fine.
Good. Yeah. My name is Bruce. What's your
name? My name is Martin de Jong. Okay. I'm from the Netherlands, actually from the north part, the Frisian, which is the homeland of the black and white Frisian cattle. And
what is happening here?
Yeah, genetics. Yeah, Blessed Dairies is an all-round company who has a division in cattle export. We have a division in genetics. We are dairy farmers ourselves in the Netherlands, but also in Kenya, in Eldoret. I'm representing the consultancy part, consulting and advising. And we mainly do training and advising farmers in order to produce more milk against lesser cost. So we are engaged with the Tide project, but we also advise in Pearl, Lato Milk, where we are training and guiding about 1,000 farmers to be more, instead of being a cattle keeper, to be a dairy farmer.
Okay. How is dairy farming different with this in the Netherlands, different from that in Uganda?
Yeah, it's completely different because here in Uganda, people keep cattle. Mm-hmm. In Holland, we are dairy farmers. We see dairy farming as a business. It's business you have to invest to harvest, like this Expo Harvest Money. You have to invest in cows, in technology, to make profit. So here it is more a family-based operation, also in the Netherlands. But for us it is very much geared towards productivity, making money. Harvesting milk in order to make money.
Okay.
So it's not a charity operation.
Is it a business?
Yeah.
Give people tips apart from technology. Give some dairy farmers in Uganda some tips on how best they can make they can make money from their business.
Yeah, that's good. It's quite simple, because milk is 87% water. So if you don't put water in the cows, you never get milk out. So cows in this climate would drink about 100 liters of water each day. Currently, farmers are giving them 10, 20, 30 liters. And they should have water available at time. People saying we are short of water. No, you have two raining seasons. So if you do collection of the water, it's all free of cost. That just make a nice swimming pool in a hill. You collect the water. You use solar panels to pump up to the cows, and they can drink at night. So very simple. Second part is forage, is feeding. Cows need rumen fill. If you feel happy, you can produce more milk. And all ingredients you have here. And we can see the farmers we are guiding in Barara, they increase the production from 7 liters a day to 15 liters a day. Only you making use of the local resources. And we say to farmers, don't look at things you are missing. Look what you have. Because you have a lot, which we don't have in the Netherlands. In the Netherlands we have winter periods. Half year we cannot grow forage. So make silage. And you have high rainy season. Preserve the fodder for a dry season, and you can have year-round milk production. So it's not magic, it's just simple things.
Okay, Viska, how have you found the Harvestman Expo?
Good, very nice. We were there 3 years when the first time was there. Mm-hmm. It was a very little, not actually a show yet, just a trial. Okay. And we're now on the third or the fourth, I think, Money Harvest, and each year it's getting better organized. Okay. Well, either way it's organized, and the layout is spacious. The quality of visitors is also good. In some fairs you have busloads of students and small children coming to grab pens and caps. Here you have more quality. So we like the Money Harvest very much.
Okay, interesting. So as we conclude, how can farmers get to you, dairy farmers? How can they contact you for information?
Yeah, they get the information that when you go to the website, it's www.blessdairies.nl. We also establishing a local office, most likely in Barara. They can also contact us through the Dutch embassy. They talk about Blessed Dairies, or through the SFV project, or you contact Pearl Dairies, or Santos, or Lakeside Dairies. They all know us.
It has been nice hanging with you. Thank you for sharing that information. Let me hope dairy farmers here in Uganda can borrow something from you. Dairy farmers, they've told you what you have to do. A cow gives milk. If you want to sell milk from your cattle. And the only one thing I've gotten from this farmer here is that if you want to get milk from your cattle, which, and by the milk is water, you have to give your cattle a lot of water. And don't forget the feeds to give you the best for your business. Now make your dairy farm a business and get the best when you just follow the tips from this farmer here. I am Ruth Nasaje. I'm still with you. We are still hanging out in the Dutch village and giving you the updates that you need from this Harvest Money Expo. See you next time. Keep locked here.